Could you show everybody who's watching this video your t-shirt that you're wearing right now?
Oh yeah, so I'm wearing HODL.
HODL, fun, but, sell.
Yeah, but then like, you know, HODL is not investment advice, just so everybody knows that. Great to hear about that.
I wish I had HODL on with my Bitcoin and not foolishly invested in other altcoins.
Oh yeah, I know the feeling. I've done that like way too many times, like and got burnt.
So you've been in the crypto space for a long while now.
I would say like late 2016.
Tell me more about what you do at eToro and how you're involved with the space.
So at eToro, I am the English copywriter and a junior analyst. So as a copywriter, like I work with a lot of marketing material, and as an analyst, I look into the markets and more specifically the crypto markets.
Yeah. Let's start off today's discussion about the cryptocurrency market. All the chatter that we have heard on the crypto space is about Bitcoin. Altcoin is not getting any love. Litecoin is getting some love.
Yeah.
But generally, altcoin have not raised with the big brother Bitcoin.
So if you look at the pattern, right, if you've always noticed like Bitcoin, the big brother like moves first, and then you see like the altcoins like slowly rising. And I think after the whole crypto winter that we had, Bitcoin is coming out strong. A lot of institutional investment coming into the space. Bitcoin fundamentals are quite strong. Now, I think we've entered like an era of consolidation. People are not just looking into Bitcoin as the future, but they're actually using it. AT&T started using Bitcoin as a form of payment.
Just have to Google up Bitcoin prices and you will get polar opposites of everyone just trying to, right? Some say 100,000, 50,000. Some people, bet that you're going to suck their own dick at 50,000. and on the other end of the spectrum, we have experts that also said that it's going to consolidate, pull back to 8,000, 6,000. So for those of you watching this, trying to get an inkling of what Bitcoin prices will be, Sagar's guess is as good as mine, as anybody's guess out there. And it's really hard to predict what the price will be. However, looking at what happened on 30th of June, where we have just, or rather rumors has it that a whale sold Bitcoin, shorted Bitcoin for what, 20 million?
Yeah.
And that created ripple in the entire industry and Bitcoin fell 8.5%. So even if we had a crystal ball trying to predict the price of Bitcoin, all it takes is just for one rich whale to sneeze and everything changes.
I think that's also the problem, right, with the crypto space, is if you look at like traditional markets, fundamentals really come into play, technicals come into play, but in crypto, we're still at like an early stage. Bitcoin is only, what, 10 years old? And you still have like all these big players like who can really change the market at will.
The other big news that has made headlines in the month of June is the Libra coin. And people have said that because Facebook has embraced cryptocurrency, therefore the rest of the public has embraced Bitcoin and the price go up.
I've seen a lot of backlash from the crypto community, which again is expected because it's a big multinational coming into the crypto space, right?
Yeah.
But I try to take this news in the positive sense, just because it brings more people to the table for discussion. A player like Facebook and I think 26 or 28 odd multinationals that have joined the consortium, that adds more legitimacy to the space, which is much required.
But it's also debatable, right? When you have all these big names like Visa, PayPal, eBay coming on board the consortium or the council, as what Hashgraph has declared, wouldn't this seem to just put all the financial elites back into one bracket and make Libra a coin that is the global coin for the elites to play with?
Probably, but then we also need to see like the whole point of like having cryptocurrencies is like is decentralization, which again, let's say the white paper does say like moving in like 5 years they will be like more decentralized, right? And so again, like, you know, it's all speculations at this point, but I feel like for like a tokenized future that we like hope to achieve, I think Facebook coming out with the Libra coin is like a step in the right direction.
Nurul Rubini, Dr. Doom, who's famous for bashing a cryptocurrency all the time. He's now bashing Libra coin and saying Facebook is monopolizing cryptocurrency. But despite all that, despite all the bashing that's going to happen or that has happened, we are still seeing Facebook as this giant who's going to bulldoze their way through. And if you were to borrow the same analogy as you would with Tesla and Edison, where Tesla came up with most of the invention, but Edison had the resource and the influence to push forward their idea and then overtook Tesla's invention and Tesla died a broke man. Could we possibly also see the demise of Bitcoin just, you know, being relegated to a small group of cryptocurrency maximalists just playing around with that store of value asset, but the actual use case of currency or digital currency in the future might be a Libra coin?
I also feel like it's not a competitor to Bitcoin.
Mm.
I feel it's a competitor to most of the central banks because it's going to be like, you know, they're holding in reserve like a basket of currencies and short-term like sort of debt assets, right? The major hurdle for them is like is the regulatory hurdle. And again, the regulators, I think, would not be concerned about it being a cryptocurrency, but then, you know, like it being able to like really just like potentially replace that.
I know. I like where this line of thought is going towards. It's almost conspiracy theory level, right? Where we think that Facebook is the big evil, but Facebook has a bigger evil to contend with, which is the central banks and the feds and the regulators. So is this a case where the enemy of my enemy is my friend? Also, with the cryptocurrency market, we have seen that the stock market, especially with Trump and Xi shaking hands and, you know, with the trade deal moving forward, Brexit is still being talked about, but the stock market has gone up. Wall Street is being very bullish right now. And I understand that at eToro, you guys do more than just cryptocurrency.
Like eToro always has been quite popular among traders, just because of the fact you mentioned, like we are a multi-asset platform. So I think that there are very few platforms out there that provide stocks, commodities, ETFs, indices, Forex and crypto, like all in one place. And again, for anybody who's looking to diversify their portfolio, I think eToro offers like one of the best options.
So thanks to you, I have actually tried eToro. So for those of you watching, this is actually episode 5 of a 5-part eToro series. And if you want to find out more about what I have learned, in fact, in the first couple of episodes, I was learning trading philosophies and principles from non-crypto traders. At the end of, I would say maybe 8 hours of sitting down with these experts, I'm still no wiser about trading than I was yesterday. But I thought one very good function that you guys have, which was amazing, was the copy trade function.
One thing I really love about the eToro platform, and I don't say that because I work for eToro, but is the whole, like it's made financial investment, like financial services more inclusive. Probably not many platforms that let even people who don't have any trading experience or who have no idea about financial markets to invest in the financial markets, right? That is what eToro has done with copy trading. And I have a lot of friends who also have like have no experience trading. Some actually also did start as crypto traders, right? But after a point, you want to diversify your portfolio, you realize like, okay, investing in like a certain asset might be quite risky. And with copy trading, you can actually do that. You can look into other profiles of investors and check out their risk source, check out their performance, and then allocate a certain amount.
You also rightly mentioned that cryptocurrency is a very volatile market and you want to hedge your risk, you want to be able to park your money elsewhere. Maybe you're one of the early crypto people in 2016 or 2017 who have made your millions. And now you're wondering, where are you going to park your money instead of buying a yacht or a condo or a mansion, right? Or a Lambo for that matter. You want to grow your wealth. What else can you do besides putting your money back into more altcoins? And that's where we start looking at assets in the market. But the main problem that I have, and I think most of us have, is we don't know how to trade.
So definitely, like copy trading is one of the key features that even personally, like I really enjoy. The second thing I would say is also we have like copy portfolios. We have this one called Crypto Takeover, which in which we are the portfolio is long on crypto and then short on banks.
Oh, I like that. I think I'm gonna follow that portfolio. eToro is a platform that I personally would recommend. I've tried it myself. If you want to see how it fared for me, check out on this links above as well as below, depending on which platform you're watching this video. I have actually gone through the platform and gave a tutorial to you guys to show you how easy it is to get started in eToro, putting in your money. In fact, if you are too afraid of losing your hard-earned cash, eToro have a special function that gives you a virtual currency for you to just play around, get a feel of the whole system before putting in real money inside. So I think what these guys have done at eToro is really connecting with the people. The UI, the UX is slick. The functions have all been well thought up for the layperson who don't really know about trading to get into trading just by following people. So give these guys, go check these guys out in the links below. I guarantee you won't regret it. And also, if you have other comments that you want to talk about, leave it in a comment below. I'll make sure Sagar reads it and we can have a future discussion on more cryptocurrency topics.
Definitely, yeah. That sounds great.
Do like and subscribe to this channel and we'll see you guys in the next video. Sagar, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pleasure having you on the show.
Pleasure talking to you. Bye.
Bye-bye.